Praise the Lord and good morning, saints and friends. We truly give an honor and praise to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to all who are in the building today. Truly just thank God just for this wonderful day set aside for our sister Lisa and our brother Harold today to get married. And when I was asked to do a reading for their wedding, at first I told my sister Pat, I said, sure, no pressure. Never done a reading for a wedding before. And I began to think of what could I say, or what can I do, put together, that would do this couple justice. And I was listening in my car one day, and a song came on called Dear Younger Me. And I said, that's it. And I said, Lord, when I sit down and do this reading, please just let it flow. So saints, the reading is called Dear Younger Me, and it's going to be a moment, I imagine, that our young couple standing up here, if they can go back and talk to themselves, their younger selves, what they might say to them this day. Dear younger me, I wish I could tell you of this day, the most spectacular, the most wonderful and blessed day of our life. I wish I could tell you that all the nights we cried ourselves to sleep, believing no one loved us and no one would ever do it. But this was not true. The energy that we wasted trying to be someone that we were not, trying to please people so they would leave us and accept us, does end. Oh, younger me, we knelt, we cried, and laid before God wondering, when, Lord, when will I be happy? When will my turn come? And even when God whispered in our hearts that he sees and understands that for us he had planned, for a minute we were content, but the sadness would return. They always seem to return. Younger me, I wish I could tell you that our living and praying was not and are not in vain. Being young, we want it now. No, we want it yesterday. And when it doesn't happen, we doubt that it ever will. Dear sweet younger me, I wish I could tell you of the love God has sent our way. They love us for who we are. They love us for what we are, our flaws and all. When they look at us, we feel and are comforted knowing they will always be at our side, protecting us, loving and caring us, sharing the good and through the bad, when happy and when sad. Younger me, I wish I could show you this day coming in our life, how we will stand with the love of our life, ready to become husband and wife. How we will stand before God, family, and friends, vowed not only to love and cherish, but reaffirm that we are truly in love with each other, and that together, with prayer, fasting, and staying before God, we can and we will make it. Dear younger me, please fret no more. God's promises do come to pass, for today I am happy, so very happy. Thank God I am free and in love at last.
Thank you.
Marriage is honorable, is an honorable state created, instituted by God, signifying unto us the mystic union, but also rest between Christ and the church. So too may this marriage be adorned the true and abiding love. Should there be anyone who has cause why this couple should not be united in holy matrimony, let them speak now or forever hold their peace. All right. Who brings this woman to this man?
I do. Today truly is a glorious day the Lord has made. As today, both of you are blessed with God's greatest of all gifts, the gift of abiding love and devotion between a man and a woman. All present here today, and those here in heart, wish both of you all joy, happiness, and success, and the world has to offer. All right, at this time, we can now face each other. Holding hands. All right, repeat after me. Paralyze up, do you take Lisa Marie to be your wife? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others and holding only to her forevermore? Lisa Marie, do you take Harold Alonzo to be your husband? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others? All right. Harold and Lisa Marie, as the two of you come together in marriage, uniting your hands and uniting you as husband and wife, and you this day affirm your faith and love for one another, I would ask that you always remember to cherish each other as a special and a unique way, that you respect the thoughts, ideas, and suggestions of one another. Be able to forgive, do not hold any grudges, and live each day that you may share it together. As for this day, and from this day forward, you shall be each other's home, comfort, refuge, your marriage strengthened by your love and respect. All right. At this time, what token do you have to make this official? Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we thank you, we praise you for this couple, Lord God. Today they would like to give rings to honor their marriage, Lord God. We ask you to bless our partner with these rings, Lord God. Help them to ever remember what they represent, Lord God. Pray your blessing upon their marriage from this day forward. In Jesus' name. All right. Lord Jesus. Brother Harold, repeat after me. I, Harold, take thee, Lisa Marie, to be my wife. I promise you love, honor, and respect, to be faithful to you, and forsaking all others. Until death do us part. Thank you. And that's so much as the two of you have both agreed to live together in holy matrimony. I promise your love for each other by these vows, the giving of these rings and the joining of hands. I now pronounce you husband and wife. Bishop, can you pray on this
topic?
All right.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Ask the Lord, desire to wish this couple success in your marriage, just to point toward them as we be this prayer. Gracious Father, we thank you. We bless your holy name, O God. Father, we thank you, Lord God, for Brother Harold and Sister Lisa, O Lord. Pray, O God, that you will look upon them on this day, Lord. We thank you even for their families, O God. Even these that claim to share, to witness, O God, this great celebration. Lord God, we thank God even for your word and for them, oh God, hallelujah, having a passion for your word, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, even for this institution, oh Lord God, that you, Lord God, hallelujah, have first created, oh God, we thank you. Lord, they entered into the sanctuary, Lord God, as two individuals. Lord God, but they go out, Lord God, hallelujah, beginning their journey of becoming one flesh. We thank you and we praise you. We thank you, hallelujah, and we praise you. Lord God, I pray that you will look over them, Lord God. Guide them every step of the way, Lord God. You can do the good times and even the not so pleasant, Lord God. Have your way, Lord God. In your home, in their lives, within their family, Lord God.
Congratulations, son.
Hallelujah.
You're right. Yeah.